Silicon Valley censorship has radically escalated over the past several months, banning pre-election reporting by the New York Post about the Biden family, denouncing and deleting multiple posts from the former U.S. President Donald Trump, and then terminating his access altogether. And now Twitter is implementing a crowdsourced censorship form called Birdwatch to combat misinformation online, hoping to build a community to help moderate and label tweets. Is this model worth trying on social media platforms?
I mean, I have a huge problem is, again, free speech. The First Amendment is the foundation of our freedom. And I think the big tech companies overplayed their hand. They got so caught up in the anti-Trump movement that they flexed their muscles in a way that has alienated over 100 million Americans. They had monopolies. There was no way that anyone was going to be able to challenge these businesses. But because of these egregious actions, there are now 100 million plus Americans ready to migrate to new platforms. I think this will ultimately be the demise of their monopolies. They overplayed their hand, and now we see.
It's true. So I know I want to move. I am like so, I mean, I was already done with Facebook. I left Insta, just like the pictures. But I mean, the whole nine, Twitter, I'm kind of like, they're following all the censorship too. I'm over it.
It's true. I know Eddie said last time, he's like, I'm completely off Facebook. I'm still with IG, but I've been contemplating it recently. But I wanted to ask you this, because isn't Twitter already filled with enough bird watchers? I mean, to me, doesn't a group of unverified fact checkers raise concern about a potential use of war in online information?
Right. I think it's kind of a, whenever Twitter and anyone else, Facebook, started this whole policing content with a select group who you have no idea who they are somewhere. You don't know where they live. You don't know who exactly it is, policing content, putting labels on things. It was very antithetical to what their product and what they were providing was. It was supposed to be about direct communication between people, and you have a discussion, and that was kind of enough because people could watch that play out in real time. Now you have just this unknown, this shadowy group that's placing labels on things and in ways that really make no sense. The biggest question I ever had, and it goes back to when the Hunter Biden story on both Twitter and Facebook was censored, is when it's a breaking story, when it's an exclusive story, how do you fact check that? And what makes you more qualified than anyone else to say, this isn't real, or we can't verify this yet? Well, that's not really a fact check, because this is new information. If it's new information, there's nothing to really put it up against. So, excuse me.
Well, I could tell you this, Eddie, because I was watching a PBS special. It was called We the Young People. And I just found out that 16-year-olds can become fact checkers. So while you are a nationally recognized journalist, thank the Lord, I guess we have the Gen Z to fix this whole situation.
Right. A 16-year-old telling me that my stuff can be checked, okay? I'm like, honey, go pay some rent.
Hey,
go
look it up. I mean, it's on YouTube right now. PBS, We the Young People. But Brock, I want to throw this at you, because where do we go with freedom of speech in America when Parler gets shut down?
Again, this is just shocking that this has happened. And yeah, for those that don't know, all of a sudden, First Amendment, free speech being censored all over the place, to the point that they've censored the sitting president of the United States of America, yeah, which means no one is safe. So a bunch of people start flocking to another application, Parler, that's supposed to be a censorship-resistant social network. And what do? Google and Apple, and I had a lot of respect for Apple, removed them from the App Store. And then Amazon shuts down their hosting. This is very, very alarming. Now, I've got some good news. There's this thing called blockchain technology, where we've been building censorship-resistant infrastructure for financial services, for social networking, for messaging, et cetera. And it couldn't come at a better time. And so I would expect to see an emergence of new applications that are censorship-resistant coming out this year.
And just like Brock said, real quick, I think.
All right, go ahead.
Okay.
I think just real quick, I think that Brock is right about this ending the monopolies. I mean, how you get a Fox News, which is the bane of the rest of the media's existence, how you get a Donald Trump is enough people in this country decide, you know what, they're not listening to me, or they don't like me very much, so we're going to do things a little bit differently. And I think what Brock is saying, that's going to break up the monopolies. It turned out you don't need the government to do this. We're going to do this on our own.